in your community. There is a need in your community or another country that you are the only one God can use to meet that. Hello? I want to hear him. I said, wherever you are sitting, there are needs all around, even in other countries, that you are the only one God can use to meet that. But at the moment, you might not even be in that country, or you are in that country, and you are struggling with some little things. Certain things has to be dealt with in order for you to be in the place to fulfill the Great Commission. So let's look at this story. We hear that now Naaman, captain of the host of the king of Syria, was a great man with his master and honorable. Look at the man they are describing. Naaman, captain of the host of the kings of Israel, an army general who looks after all the military in Syria. He was a honorable man, and by him the Lord had given deliverance unto Syria. Because of this man, God has given him so many victories in battles. He was also a mighty man in valor, but he was a leper. Say he was a leper. Look at all the description they gave about this man. And they said, but he has a skin disease, a terrible skin disease, incurable in those days. Over 3,000 years ago, the skin disease he had was incurable then and is still incurable today. When you get leprosy, you cannot be healed medically. Medicine has not discovered medicine that cures leprosy. Despite the accolades of this man, he had this skin disease that eats your skin. It eats your fingers. With time, your fingers will be gone. Your lips will be gone, and only your tooth will be shown. Your nose will be gone, you will be left with only the holes. Part of your eyes, ears, foot. It's an ugly disease. Of all the sickness that will attack this army general, successful military officer, it was this incurable disease. But I find this strange. When somebody contracts leprosy, that person should be banished from society. But because of this man's position, his achievement, they didn't banish him. In fact, the family who should be concerned, they were keeping him at home. He was still with home with his wife and children, putting the whole family, both wife and children, at stake. Because this disease can be transmitted to other people. It's just like COVID. You can pass it on. So it baffles me why the leaders of Assyria decided to keep this man among them and wearing military uniform to cover this sickness. Beloved, there are so many people in society who are covering themselves with things. There are politicians. There are husbands, wives, children. We have so many things at home, we are covering up. Some of these things are deadly and dangerous. But we cannot afford losing our loved ones So we are doing everything to harbor this dangerous malady of sicknesses and diseases. And the word of God says, and the Syrians had gone out by companies and had brought away captive out of the land of Israel a little maid who waits on Naaman's wife. And she said unto her mistress, would God, my Lord, were with the prophet that is in Samaria, for he will recover him of his leprosy. Hallelujah. Who told you you cannot do anything? Who told you that there is no value for your life? Who told you that your words will not count? What limits are you putting on yourself? We were told that this army general led his people into Israel. They conquered Israel. They took whatever they would take from Israel. And he took some people's slaves. He brought it to his home to serve him and his family. And out among these slaves that he had taken, there was a little girl. We were not told how old this girl was. But there was this little girl among the slaves that he has, who was serving the wife of this man. This is very common in this country or other places, Africa. We normally get house heads to help, especially those who are a little bit financially okay. Sometimes you see the children of these people bully these house heads. They treat them like trash. They wash their clothes. They cook for them. Sometimes it doesn't, I don't understand. The children of these rich people spoil children. These house heads are taking care of them, cook their meals, wash for them, sometimes even iron. And they still treat them like trash. And you know, funny enough, these rich parents may send their children to schools overseas, abroad. And then some of these children grow up and become worse than the house heads. Sometimes most of their house heads do better than these rich people's children. Most of these children end up in alcohol, drugs, and all kinds of things, and they become a problem to the family. Hallelujah. Naaman stumbled on this young child, but this girl knows God. Hallelujah. Now, the whole thing, this whole story is amazing. These people said God has forsaken them. God has given them to the Assyrians. The Assyrians have defeated them. Please listen to this story carefully. Yet this girl said to her mistress, if my master will go to the prophet of God in Samaria, he will recover his leprosy. Now, we know Elijah did so many things, but we don't know if he had cleansed somebody from leprosy. But I don't want you to think far. Jesus told us, even if you don't know, we don't know. I don't know where this girl got her testimony from. But she was bold enough to say, we have a God in Israel. We have a prophet in Israel. that can cure your problem. Now, there is something about this young girl that probably her mistress has identified. So, when this young girl said that to the mistress didn't say, "Shut up. What are you talking about? You are a slave girl. What have you got to do with your mistress and your master's relationship?" You know where we come from. This girl would have been shut up. But for some reason, this woman took this young girl's words serious. She said, "I might be a slave. You may have captured me. But we still have a God. He warned us. Our fathers and our leaders didn't listen. That's why we have become slaves to you. But that God still hasn't changed." Hallelujah. Amen. No matter your circumstances, don't forget that the God, if there is a God you have put your hope in, and in the true and the living God, He does not change. Hallelujah. And your circumstances will not limit Him from doing whatever He has said He will do. Say amen.
Amen.
I'll be quick so we continue the story this week. They took this girl serious. And somebody went in and told his Lord, saying, "Thus and thus said a maid that is of the land of Israel." This is what the girl from Israel said. And the king of Syria, now, this girl's words carry so much weight that it went beyond her home. It went beyond her mistress and her master Naaman. This girl's testimony about their God, children, listen. You should be able to testify about the God of your fathers, but you have to know this God for yourself. Such was great value placed on this young girl's words that statement she made went all the way to the king, the chambers of the king of Assyria. And the king of Syria said, go, and I will send a letter unto the king of Israel. Based on the words of this young girl, a diplomatic letter was issued. How important are you? How serious are you? How truthful are you? Do you know God so much that even in a strange and foreign land, you can declare that I may be a foreigner in your land. You may be treating me, I might be a slave in your home. But I have a God, hallelujah, who does wonders, who does miracles. Her words was then into a diplomatic letter with the executive stamp of the king of Syria. And the letter reads like this. "And he departed and took with him 10 talents of silver and 6,000 pieces of gold and 10 changes of raiment. And he brought the letter to the king of Israel, saying, Now when this letter is come unto thee, behold, I have therewith sent Naaman my servant to thee, that thou mayest recover him of his leprosy." This is what the letter says. Now, the young girl didn't say there is a king in Israel. He said there is a prophet. Hallelujah. There is a prophet in Israel. But the letter was addressed to the wrong person. The letter was not addressed to the prophet. It was addressed to the king. Wrong person. Why am I saying this? You have to know the God yourself. And when you are praying, you have to know the kind of God you pray to. Hallelujah. You have to know the God you are praying to. There are many who are praying to the wrong God. I hear people say, hey, Mary, pray for me. Mary doesn't pray for nobody. You are praying to the wrong God. Listen to what the girl said. Listen to what the pastor preached. Make sure you understood the message. And do what you have to do to get the right result. Hallelujah. They didn't listen. I don't know if probably because she spoke and the message was passed around, by the time the letter, the words got to the king, it has been diluted. So the king ordered the letter to the king of Israel, said, recover my army general for me. And they sent some gifts. Hallelujah. And it came to pass, when the king of Israel had read the letter, when the king of Israel had read the letter, that he tore his clothes and said, am I God to kill and to make alive, that this man that sent unto me to recover a man of his leprosy? Wherefore consider, I pray you, and see how he seeks quarreling against me. If you go to the right, wrong person, you will not get the right results. Hallelujah. I started by saying people who aim at wrong people for certain reason. Where do you get the information from? When you're looking for a church to attend, you are looking for a prayer meeting, you are looking for something, who do you listen to? They pick wrong person. And we read over here that the king said, I cannot do what he's requesting. And the king said, he's picking the program with me. Hallelujah. Misinformation. You see, misinformation is can be very, very bad. And when it goes wrong, it can terribly cause a damage. The whole message of this young girl was misunderstood, misconstrued. And now look at the ripples. So the king of Israel said, this man is speaking a problem. I am not God. I don't heal. I cannot heal. And it came to pass, verse 8, and it was so when Elisha, the man of God, had heard that the king of Israel has torn his clothes, he sent to the king saying, why have you torn your clothes? Let the man come to me now, and he shall know that there is a prophet in Israel. Hallelujah. The message the young girl gave, that there was a prophet in Israel, they went to a king. Where do you seek answers from? Where do you seek your solutions from? Which church do you attend? Where do you work? How did you choose your wife? How did you choose your husband? The school your children are attending. The kind of community you want to live in. The work you are living. On what grounds do you take vital decisions? The prophet of God didn't know that there is a young girl who has spoken highly of him in the corridors of authority. Hallelujah. What are other people saying about you? What have people been saying about you, my sister, my brother? You sitting in this room, what are people saying about you? Are they talking about your faith? Are they talking about your good works in God? This young girl, far away in the land of slavery, was pointing to them. She represented God in the foreign land. May you represent God in this land. Hallelujah. May message never go to back to your country where you come from. Those of you in the diaspora, there should be no message from diaspora going back to your country of origin saying that you are in prison, you are dealing with cocaine, you are dealing with drug, all kinds of bad things. May it never be so. Hallelujah. This girl was representing God in slavery. And they took her away so serious that a whole nation moved. Oh, I love this girl. One day when we go to heaven, I would like to see this girl. And I would like to know where she got her faith from. Hallelujah. The prophet said, let a man come to me that he will know that there is a prophet in Israel. I see he knew. That's exactly what the girl told him. Hallelujah. Let him come now to me and he shall know that there is a prophet in Israel. So Naaman came with his horses and with his chariots and stood at the door of the house of Elisha. And Elisha sent a messenger unto him, saying, go and wash in Jordan 7 times, and your flesh shall come again to you, and you shall be clean. Hallelujah. Say they came. No, say after me, they came with horses.
They came with
chariots. This man has everything. Chariots, if you were today, chains of cars, came with the best traveling vehicles in their time, chariots and horses. So